Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I'm feeling the need for a new adventure, and this is the beginning of that, possibly. On our community, in the YouTube community, we get lots of great questions that people are asking. Plus, I get, on a daily basis, wonderful questions emailed to me from people wanting to know a little bit more about getting the most out of their technology. And it got me thinking, perhaps what I should be doing is a weekly Ask Dotto Tech video. So this is a grand experiment. This is Ask Dotto Tech version 1. I'm going to answer a few of your questions, talk to you about a few of the things that seem to be top of mind amongst the community. And if you like it, I need you to comment below so that I know that this is a video that I should be producing each and every week. So sit back, relax, and enjoy Ask Dotto Tech episode 1. Alrighty then. We are going to answer your questions as best we can here on Ask Dotto Tech. And here's one that came from Joel, and it's an interesting question. He says, I have a Mac. Good for you, Joel. And my friend has a Windows computer. Good for him, too. But he does not have Evernote. Come on, friend, wake up. He said, Joel says that we share a Dropbox folder. He wants us to send him an Evernote notebook into our shared Dropbox folder. Can this be done? He tried looking at it, but nothing seems to work. Yes, nothing will work, Joel, because what you don't really, what you haven't understood here is the nature of Evernote. Evernote is not like isn't a document format like Word or PDF. Evernote is a contained unit where all of the different notes that we put in Evernote live within that closed environment. Having said that, there's a very easy way for you to share notes with your friend even if they don't have Evernote, and I'm going to show you that right now. I'm just going to pop into my Evernote account right here, and this is actually a shared notebook that I use along with Brooks Duncan. This is the notebook that we share for delivering our Paperless Office Made Easy course. But if you go into your Evernote account, now pay attention to this sequence. You go into your Evernote account, go into the notebook or the notes that you want to share with your friend, click on the share icon or the share tool here in the top right-hand corner of Evernote in your Evernote app. There you can copy a public link or you can share the notebook. If you decide to share the notebook, he will need an Evernote account to be able to access all of the content. But if you just want to share a single note or multiple notes with him, all you have to do is copy the public link. This creates a little bit of magic. What happens is Evernote converts this note into a shared link, and I've just got notification that it's been copied now to my clipboard. If I go into my web browser, and paste that link. So if you email this link here to your friend, what will happen is they will then gain access to that Evernote note, and they can see it. And it doesn't matter whether they have Evernote or not, they can see the note in their web browser. That's going to be the easiest way for you to share information. You don't need Dropbox for this because Dropbox is where you share files. Instead, Evernote is, as I said, all of the content is contained within the Evernote ecosystem, as it were, so that unless you export the note in some sort of file format as a PDF or something like that, you can't share the notes anyway except this one here that I've just showed you. But this is pretty slick. And it should work for you, and it should work for your friend. But seriously, friend, start using Evernote. Don't you think he should? I think he should. All right, let's jump over into the YouTube channel itself and take a look at some of the different comments and questions that you're asking me in YouTube. Now, if you haven't checked out the comment section below, I need you to now because I need you to comment and tell us that you like this video format, that you like the Ask Dotto Tech, if indeed you do like Ask Dotto Tech. But as I scroll through this, I find a couple of different questions in multiple languages, actually. Today I got a question from Volker, actually yesterday from Volker, who said he really appreciates the good work I do. Thank you very much, Volker. I wonder if there's any feature that allows Google Photos to find duplicates. Of course, we just posted a video last week about Google Photos. I quite like it, and I think certainly the response that we've got on the channel is most of you like what Google Photos is offering. Asking about finding duplicates and automatically basically eliminating duplicates. duplicates to save disk space. It was interesting, when Google first announced Google Photos and showed it to everybody, they did have the feature where it would go through and it would find duplicates, especially on your smartphone. It doesn't seem to be in the initial release, at least I haven't found it. If anybody has found it, let me know. But it is what it is, one of the first upgrades that I would imagine Google is going to be adding to the Google Photos toolkit. So it's, we have to remember, we're just in version one of Google Photos. They're going to be adding more and more features as it goes along, but the duplicates does not seem to be there. It's going to be very useful, especially for saving space on your smartphone when you'd like to keep a large library of photos on your smartphone. But Volker, I'm sorry, not there yet. Should be there soon. One thing that's really interesting in the comments area is it gives me a really good indication when I post a video of which products are resonating with the community. And here's one, a nice comment from Bright Spark Media. And that was commenting on the Sunrise calendar keyboard. Now, Sunrise is a calendar app that we use that combines all of our, or pulls all of our different calendars together, and it gives us a really nice interface, especially on our smartphones and tablets, for managing our calendars. So regardless if you use Outlook or if you use Google Calendar, Sunrise pulls it all together and gives you great apps on your mobile phones in order to manage it. They've also got a keyboard that I did a video on, which allows you to automatically schedule meetings, which is just a little stroke of genius. But as Brightstar Media says, wow, love it. Arranging meetings with clients and potential clients seems so frustrating to sync schedules. Definitely going to try the Sunrise app. It's so great that it syncs with any calendar, adjusts for time zones, and lets you book locations as well. So I'm just I'm going to add these add here the links to the Sunrise Meet keyboard, which is the video that she's talking about. But Sunrise Calendar, actually, I've got it right here. Let's take a quick boo at it. I've just got the Mac Store version up here, but it's available in iOS, Android, on all of your different devices. Sunrise Calendar certainly seems to be, in my mind now, and in the community's mind, a winning solution. It's one that so many people are gravitating to. All right, we're going to wrap things up with one more question, and this is a video which we posted a little over a year ago that's been a very popular video on Google Forms, Google's free online form tool that allows you to collect information through email links or through a web page, and it's a great tool for collecting information. Free, there's lots of paid services, but Google provides it for free. It's kind of one of the hidden gems that Google provides us, but it's quite a technical solution ultimately. We show you in the video how it works, and we'll put a post to the video here. But I get a lot of questions on this particular product. In fact, over the last year, we've had 388 comments on it. And the bulk of those are people asking little technical details of times that they kind of bump their head on the app. Now, I just don't have the technical expertise to answer all of the questions. For example, Road to Reason TV asked me a few weeks ago, they're having trouble. They're saying, I'm trying to make Google Form work where it makes a full copy, just like when it was filled out. It does not keep the questions, only the answers. So they actually want the full answer sheet to be captured. I don't know how to do that. I've never had to do that. However, I do have access or have found this Google support forum, which I'm going to encourage you all to take a look at. I'll post a link in the description below for the Google Drive help form. But regardless of which app you use, especially in Forms and Gmail and Sheets, all of the different Google apps, this is the place to go to search for answers and to post problems that you can't find answers to. Now, I encourage you to ask me the questions as well within our community. After all, that is what this video is about today. But if it's too technical, we're going to direct you to Google Drive, and it's a good place to look, especially if you want a quick answer for anything. So once again, that link will be in the description field below. And that brings the first episode of Ask Dottotech to a close. You got to tell me if you like it. If you do, comment below and tell me that you want more of these videos. I'm seriously considering producing this once a week. Now, one last thing, and that is, you might notice that we've not been running any ads on this particular video, and we won't be running ads in the Ask Dottotech series, because Ask Dottotech is brought to you by you, my supporters at Patreon. If you don't know about Patreon and you don't know the relationship between Patreon and Dottotech, Dottotech is funded through, a large part of our funding comes through the people who watch and view the videos on our channel at Patreon. I encourage you to drop by the Patreon page. The link is here as well well as in the description field below. But if you drop in and take a look, we ask you to support us financially. And in return, there are perks. Not just the great video continues to keep flowing out of Dottotech, which it will do, but there's some real tangible perks like access to our courses, our great courses, which we now have. Oh, we're only closing in on 500 of you being our patrons, which is a thrill for me. I appreciate it. You get extra deep access to me answering your questions, as well as access to our courses. So I encourage you to drop in and have a look at our Patreon page and see if you want to join in on the Dottotech community. And that is it for today. I hope that you've enjoyed this video. I'm looking forward to reading your comments. Until next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.